Moi, les gars. The top one for the first 300. A question, okay. This is true or false. Potter was the surname of Del Boy and Rodney in TV's Only Fools and Horses. Potter was the surname of Del Boy and Rodney in TV's Only Fools and Horses. Is that true or false?
False.
And Trotter is right, £300. Well done, over you come. Okay, for £600, just come up a little bit with Rosa. Well done. Just a tiny bit bad so I can see the screen. Top, middle or bottom, where are you going?
Bottom.
Bottom.
The bottom one for £600. Ooh, okay, that's one gone. You've got £300 for £600. Top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
Bottom.
The bottom one again, you're going on the stand on the bottom. Ooh. This happens a lot of times. Okay, no more hot spots. People have got to wait across here.
Top.
Hey?
Top.
Top for 600. Let's go, Brick. Come on. Yes. All right. For £900, top, middle or bottom?
Yeah. Bottom. Hey? Bottom.
The bottom one for 900. Yes. Here we go. All right. Okay. For £1,200.
Medal.
Hey?
Medal.
The middle one for £1,200. Cool. Question. Okay, here we go. Robin Ray animates the puppet Lord Charles. Is that true or false?
False.
That's right, Ray Allen, that's it, 1,200. Okay, for £1,500, top, middle or bottom?
Medal.
Yes?
Medal.
Go for the middle one again for 1,500. Oh, bad luck, let's give him a nice round of applause. Come on, Mark, come down here. Just stand either side of me. There you go. You all right?
Hi.
Let's have a look at the screens. Let's see where they all were. There you go. All right. Well, never mind. Let's tell you what you're going to take away with you tonight. The two of you, are you ever going to get married, you two?
When he asks.
Oh, you don't want to ask her yet. All right. Well, you can take your time. So if you hold on to all the prizes and money, you might come round. Don't worry. Right, you've got a season of Pheasant, a butler for a day, a portable TV, a dining suite, a large tablecloth. I think you might as well get married looking at this lot. A Greek holiday, that's the honeymoon, that's the contents of the house. And the money you won earlier, plus the money you won there, £1,300. You happy? All right, that's all we've got time for. Good night, good day. Good night, thank you, bye-bye.
Control stays with you as we join some more of those eccentric contestants and another Strike It Lucky next. Then it's hello, good evening and welcome to David Frost and Lloyd Grossman as we go through the keyhole. That's today at 4, new to challenge.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecha Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Which would you choose? This double duvet. Or this one from Woucher. Woucher, save now. Live wow.
Introducing Sure Non-Stop Protection, 72-hour antiperspirant plus motion sense. Tested to the limit.
Still fresh, still dry.
Upgrade to Sure 72-hour non-stop protection.
Make chafing a thing of the past. Take one giant step for mankind with Step One.
Enjoy more of the latest blockbusters on Sky Cinema with Megan.
Hi, Megan. I'm Katie.
It's nice to meet you, Katie.
Your goal is to protect Katie from harm, both physical and emotional.
I won't let anything harm you ever again.
This is the part where you run.
Hold the door!
Megan, available from the 25th of August on Sky Cinema.
Buzzcox is back, and we can't contain our excitement.
Daisy just sounds like a chicken on every attempt.
Arrows, archers, throwers and knowers. This show has all the darting fun. Game on for Bullseye. Weekdays at 5 on Challenge.
Congratulations, number 3. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
On Strike It Lucky tonight, a jackpot of £3,000. Keep all your assets frozen, win this marvellous fridge freezer. Look your best with a hairstyle created just for you by a top stylist. Or top up your tan with a holiday in the sizzling sun-drenched Canaries. All these prizes to be won tonight on Strike It Lucky. Now, ladies and gentlemen, your host, Michael Barrymore.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hey, all right?
What?
Hey, what?
What?
Want a bag? What? Hiya, how are you? Oh, okay. Arcala. Is it Arcala?
No, I'm just an instructor.
Oh, are you? Very nice. What do you instruct in?
Well, what would you like instruction in?
Good start to the show. Nice to see you. And Carl, is this mum and son, is it?
Correct.
Nice to meet you. You got all dressed up for us tonight. So, what are you?
I've been a scout for 5 years.
Yeah. Yeah, and you're still at school, Carl?
Yes.
Yeah.
At Newlands Manor School in Seaford.
Which one?
Newlands Manor School in Seaford.
And so you've got all the gear. So what are you saving up for at the moment? Anything in particular?
A coach.
Oh, what's this for?
For handicapped children. So we take handicapped children to camp every year.
You do all that, do you? Still doing all the jobs and
oh,
things?
Oh, yes.
You got enough money yet?
No.
How much you need?
Another £4,000.
Well, I'll have a chat with the others as we go along.
You will. You pass the hat round for me.
It's only 500 each. A lot of money, but we'll try and see what we can do.
Yes.
That's lovely. Yes,
I've got a few bits here for you.
Have you really?
Yes.
Oh, how nice. There we are. Oh, nice bag. There we are. Yeah, have a look. Oh, what's that?
This is a Camp Together sweatshirt.
Oh, that'll go down. Oh, Camp Together.
Yes. Wow. An honorary member.
Yes. I wouldn't wander around this studio with this on, love. I really wouldn't. Okay, production starting now. How are you? What's that one?
That's a neckerchief to go around
your neck. Oh, that's nice. Can I try that? What do you do? Yeah. I've forgotten this bit. You roll it up.
Yeah.
That's it. All right, like that. Roll it right up.
Doesn't
matter.
There's your woggle.
Hey, that's me woggle. Yeah. Where do I stick that?
You feed it up. You know how to feed things.
Have a bit of class on that production table, please. State of that. There we are. And you put that up there.
That's it.
That's it. Right. What's
and
that
now
bit?
You've got a Camp Together badge as well.
Camp Together badge. Yes. Okay. Stick that on there. Is that it? Fine.
That's
well, thank
it.
You very much indeed. I'll look after this. Save that for a minute. And I'll keep this on for the rest
oh,
of the show.
Oh, right, you are.
Go and say hello to the rest. Nice
thank
to meet you.
Very
go nice
much.
Round of applause. There we are. Hi, sir. How are you?
All right. How are you doing?
All right,
man.
All right, man. How's it going? Nice to see you. We've got some other people here with something. Let me take this because my mic's under there. Okay, so I'll put it on in a minute. Okay. So, what's your name? So it's Matt and Eileen. You married?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
And whereabouts are you from?
From Milton Hall in Suffolk.
In Suffolk?
Yeah.
Where do you work there?
I work for the Ministry of Defence, but I actually work for RAF Lagenheath, which is the United States Air Force Base at Lagenheath.
Yes, yes. And, yeah. What about yourself?
I'm retired military and I work for the American Civil Service.
You work for the American Civil Service?
Yes.
So you've got a lovely accent there. Well, whereabouts in America were you born?
Deep South, Atlanta, Georgia.
Atlanta, Georgia. Oh, lovely. Yes. That's very nice. And what do you do in the Air Force?
I am a budget accountant.
What first attracted you to Matt?
Well, actually, we met at a birthday party. That was Matt's birthday party. I went to the party with another fella. Matt was running the disco at the time, and the chap I went Ooh. With
Are
asked...
Are you DJ?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What sort of records do you like playing? Soul or anything like that?
I'm into the mellow mood, you know.
The what?
Mellow mood.
Mellow mood. What
yes.
What sort of things?
Stylistics.
Oh, yeah.
Jeffrey Osborne.
Lovely accent, isn't it?
Yeah. And what happened was... The chap that I went to the party with said to Matt, can I have a go at your equipment, you see. He wanted to be a DJ.
Nice way to talk about your wife, isn't it?
So Matt said, yeah, sure. So he said, well, while you're messing with my equipment, he said, I'll dance with yours. And we've been there ever since.
Oh, lovely story. Well, nice to meet you, Matt. Good luck. Good luck on the show. And to you, Ivy, all the best. There we are. Hi, Rich.
How do you do?
Nice to meet you. And Debbie?
Yes.
We've got Rich and Debbie here. And whereabouts are you from?
I'm from Birmingham, actually.
Few supporters as well. Mm. From Birmingham, actually. Very strong
true.
Accent.
True. Oh, yes.
Yes. And you, Debbie?
I come from Stratford-on-Avon.
With a Birmingham accent.
I lived there for a while.
And you moved down, yes. Yeah. Hey, so what's the relationship?
Oh, just friends.
You said that very quickly before she got a chance to say anything. Yeah, that's nice. And what do you do for a living, Reg?
I work at the SA office.
SA office, yes. And Debbie?
That's where I used to work as well.
That's how you met, I suppose, yeah. And what do you like, what sort of things do you like doing?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, every time I see Gene Kelly sing in the rain, and slushing about,
yeah.
I think to myself, oh, I'd love to do that. Just because there's nobody around saying, what are you doing all that for?
Because nobody's going to stop you, are they, Reg?
True.
That's it. So, I mean, I like singing in the rain, and we always do a little part of it. You want to fancy having a go?
Me and you together?
Well, yeah, or you can do it. I'll back you. We'll help you. Yeah, there we are. How are we going to do it now? Do you know the number? I'll tell you what, now we've got it because, we haven't worked this out, obviously. I'll tell you what, use this as the first part. We're Gene. You remember when Gene, right, Gene, if you're looking in, friend of yours. Right, Gene Kelly, just in case. Matt, he's from the Deep South. Originally, he's over here now. Remember, he's another American. Okay? So I'm just telling Gene Kelly, in case he's watching in, that Matt's here. All right? Okay? Right. Do you want to? We got a brolly. Anybody got it from the shop? Oh, I see. There we are. Thank you. Do you need this?
Oh yeah.
All right. We've got no music, so we'll hum it along with you. Did you start with it open or closed in the film?
Closed.
Was it closed? Hey.
Closed.
Oh, trust a scout to know. There you go. All right. Singing in the rain. Just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling. I'm happy again. Yeah, go for it.
I'm laughing at clouds.
Go on, Rich.
So dark.
Go for the legs.
The sun's in my heart.
And I'm ready for love. Let's go down the street, Reg. Let the stormy clouds chase. Go on, Reg. Everyone from the place.
Come on with the rain.
I'm a
smile on my face.
Yeah, keep near the microphone.
I walk.
Refrain. They are singing and dancing in the rain. Da 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 da. All right, now, the idea of the game is to get from one side to the other. First couple to get across gets a chance to go on a jackpot tonight and win anything up to £3,000. You tossed the coin earlier on to decide who's going first, so if your partners would like to go to their places, we can start. Let's give them a nice round of applause. Here we go. Oh, just leave that there. Thank you very much for that. All right. OK, everybody's in their places. First category for you, Carol, is trousers, 2, 3 or 4.
2, please.
Right, what kind of trousers might a Scot most likely wear? What kind of trousers may a
Scot...
Trews is right. Trews. What kind of trousers are traditionally for sailors?
Bell-bottoms.
That's right, 2 moves to yours. We're off, here we go. All right. First one, right? All right, Carl.
Yes, thanks.
First screen, we can be absolutely free, young man, so if you'd like to stand in there, strike the screen. Remember those hot spots. What is a hot spot? None? All right, strike the screen, Carl. See what you got in the first one. Fridge freezer. Do you want to bank that or is there something on the next screen?
No,
what are you going to do?
Go on.
You're going over? Yeah. All right, then. Strike the screen. £150 and the fridge freezer. Good start. All right, We go on to the next category with you, Eileen, and it's farewells. Two, three, or four. Eileen, farewells.
Two.
Right. In which country would you say adios?
Spain.
Oh, well done. Right. In which country would you say au revoir?
France.
That's right, the two moves are yours. OK, there we go. Leon down the line, oh, many miles ago. Ah, I like all the laid-back stuff, Matt. It's really good.
That's right.
That's right. I saw you doing that earlier. That's Arsenio Hall. He does that, doesn't it?
That's right.
Woo, 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 woo.
Yeah. That's excitement. Happiness.
That's happiness, is it?
That's it.
Yes, it's a coffee advert over here. Yes, a couple of other things, but we won't go on about that. Sorry, off you go, Matt.
Strong wrist.
Sorry? Oh, yes, I know what you did, yes. Off you go, Matt. Let's see what you got for your first prize. A night at the opera. Nice prize. You want a banknote or wrist or something on the next screen? What do you want to do?
Go ahead.
Go ahead, over you come, Matt. Strike the screen. Best of luck. All right. A dinner service and a night at the opera, they're yours. All right. We go on to the next category, which is solo singers. For you, Reg, solo singers.
Oh, dear.
Gotta dance.
I'll try two.
Two, right. From which group do the following solo singers originate? Sting. What? Who was Sting in?
Are they from Boney M?
No. Sorry, Rich. It's all right. Is that Sting?
Police.
Is that a guess?
Yes.
Yeah, all right. We need the youngster down here for this lot. And Phil Collins. Do you know which one? No help, please. Is that a guess?
Genesis.
Is that a guess?
Yes.
You've got two moves. They're yours. All right. OK. All right. Do you know the answers to those, Carl?
No.
You didn't? Oh. All right. OK, I'll strike the screen. This is, well, you didn't know the answers, wasn't it? All right. OK, we go on to the next category, which is mixing your drinks. Back with you now, Eileen. Two, three or four?
Two,
two. For your first move, which cocktails contain the following ingredients? Vodka and orange.
Probably a Bucks Fizz.
It's not, I'm afraid. Vodka and orange, Rich.
Would it be Bloody Mary?
No. No. No.
Vodka. Screwdriver?
OK, Guinness and champagne.
Oh, Black Velvet.
That's it, two moves are yours. All right, there we go. Racing away here, Carl, eh?
Yeah.
We'll be a badge at the end of this for you. All right.
What one, though?
Oh, what one? Home computer. Nice prize. Do you want to bank it?
What is... Move on. Oh. We've already got
one. I've got you a home computer.
I've already got one.
Yeah?
Already got one.
Oh, got one. Have you already?
Yeah. For mum's business.
Oh, for mum's business. Right. Funny game, playing Mario. Washing machine and the home video. All right. OK, there we go. Next category is Secret Services. Eileen, Secret Services.
Two.
Two. Please. In which country is the Secret Service known as the KGB?
Russia.
For which country does the CIA work?
USA.
I thought you would have known that. There we are. OK, two moves are yours. Shocked that you didn't know that one, Matt, wouldn't
That's
you?
Right.
Okay.
We'll be divorced.
Divorced to that. Well, they could have arranged it the CIA. Anyway. There you go. Oh. Well, you've lost nothing. You got that one out of the way. We go on to the next category, which is animal names for you, Reg. Now we need to get you started, so it's nice and relaxed here. Two, three, or four? Well, animal names.
I'll go for a four.
Four. Well done, Reg. Okay. Good luck. What name is given to a male ostrich? A male ostrich. What would you call a male ostrich?
I say cock.
Is right. And what name is given to a male zebra? A male zebra. What would you call a male zebra?
A book.
Is wrong, I'm afraid. What name is given to a male zebra? Do you know that, Carol?
Stallion.
Well done, well guessed. And what name is given to a male giraffe?
Jack.
Is wrong. A chance for you, Eileen. What name is given to a male giraffe? Take a guess if you're not sure. Just go for it.
Bull.
Well done. And for four moves, what name is given to a male donkey?
It's got to be Jack.
That's it. Four moves for yours. Well done. All right. There we go.
Ooh, whoa.
Oh. You started doing it then, really gorgeous. I'm glad you were like, whoa, whoa, whoa. No, okay, just do that, thank you. Oh, all right, hair by a top stylist. Do you want to bank it or go on? You're going on, come over, Matt, there we go. Oh, all right, not worried about your haircut. Okay, off. Right, next screen. A night at Stringfellow's. No? Oh, I see you thought about that one, okay. All right, strike the screen. Hotspot, he says. You're right, but you're in the lead at the moment. Okay, we go on to the next category. Back now with you, Reg. Let's try and get you off the ground. Two, three, or four. The category is animal families.
Oh, try three.
Well done, okay. Which family of animals is warm-blooded and gives birth to live young?
Mammals.
To which animal family do frogs and toads belong?
Reptiles.
No, it's wrong, I'm afraid, Jed. Sorry. To which, do you know that, Carol?
Amphibians.
And which family of animals include snakes and lizards?
Reptiles.
That's right, Freeman's yours. Okay. All right, strike three, young man. Here we go. Chandelier. Your nice chandelier. Do you want to bank it or risk it something on the next screen?
Move on.
You're going on. All right, strike the screen. Oh, lose the chandelier. We're back again now with you, Eileen. You've got two screens up there. I must ask you a minimum of two questions. Here it is on geography. In which country is Damascus? In which country is Damascus? If you're not sure, Eileen, I must have, just take a guess. I must have an answer.
Syria.
And where is Kathmandu? Kathmandu, where is it?
Nepal.
Nepal's right, Tim, is yours. OK. OK, strike the screen. There we are. Let's see what you got, Matt. A nest of tables. Do you want to bank that or is it nothing on the next screen? You going on? OK, you're coming on to the M1. Strike the screen. A week on cough. All right, now you've got to decide whether you're going to bank those two prizes or answer the main strike it lucky question. We're going to find out what they're going to do in a couple of minutes' time. See you after a break. All right, see you then. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Who's behind the door? It's number four.
If you're over 50, you can have the time of your life without worrying how your family will cope when your time is up. Post Office Over 50's Life Cover is simple and affordable, and from a name you know and trust. You're guaranteed acceptance if you're a UK resident aged 50 to 80. There are no health checks, and it starts from just £1.15 a week. Plus, you can get free 24/7 GP access with the Health and Wellbeing Benefit. Come on, enjoy yourself. Safe in the knowledge Over 50's Life Cover will pay out money when you die, as a gift. Call our UK call centre now on 0800 169 1100 and choose your £100 gift card for Amazon.co.uk, Tesco or M&S.
New Dove Body Wash is different. It cleanses your skin more gently and helps skin to moisturise from within in just one shower. Choose different. Choose Dove.
Paddy Power Bingo gives you the chance to win cash prizes from free games every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, suitor number 10.
I swipe left, footman.
Number 3.
Oh, catfishing again, I see.
Number 66.
The only way is exit.
Miss Bingoton may be unavailable, but Paddy Power Bingo is free every day.
Aw, one for my mum.
Build a plan and make it yours with Three Your Way. Pick our unlimited SIM Plus plan for only £24 a month for the first 12 months, with unmissable benefits like 28 days of worldwide roaming plus a choice of extras. Now that's big value from a big network. Search Three or head in-store to switch now.
Which would you choose? This robot vacuum cleaner? Or this one from Woucher? Woucher. Save now. Live wow.
From food and drinks to flights and transfers, there's so much included with TUI River Cruises. Plus, you can now cruise down the Nile next winter. TUI, live happy at all protected. Macmillan Coffee Morning is back this September. So let's get together and do whatever it takes for people living with cancer. Whether you're making it, baking it, even faking it. Dancing, laughing, family gathering, or just coffee and chatting. The money you raise helps us do whatever it takes for people living with cancer. There's still time to join in. Order your free coffee morning kit today by searching Macmillan Coffee Morning now.
Set for the move?
Yeah, just searching for home insurance.
Home insurance, eh? Just need your age, a job, and how flat your roof is. Same old insurance with a whizzy app.
I'll protect you, young man.
Just get Urban Jungle. You pay per month. They don't care how flat your roof is. Mine's just £5.
Done.
Urban Jungle. Finally, fair home insurance from £5 per month. MyUrbanJungle.com.
Rainforests. Get closer to islands bursting with life.
Scream has been stolen.
A theft of this nature is so extraordinary.
He was saying, "You can't catch me."
What I call lucky.
Right, welcome back to part two of Strike It Lucky. Now, the situation we have, we've got Debbie's right over the bat there, hasn't even started yet. Unfortunately, Carl's one away from the end. And Matt and Eileen, you're here on the main Strike It Lucky question. Now, you can bank the weekend cost, the holiday in cost, and the nested tables, they'll be safe, or do you want to answer the question? Remember, if you get it wrong, you lose those prizes. What are you going to do?
Go for the question.
Go on for it.
They're going to go for the question, they're going to have a go for it. OK. Come down here, Matt, just in front of me. All right, here we go. All right, I'll read you the question. You can confer as loud as you like, then I'll ask you the question again, and I must have an answer. The very best of luck. This Australian actor, who previously co-starred with Tina Turner in Mad Max, more recently struck it lucky when he received critical acclaim for his film of Hamlet. Who is he?
Mel Gibson.
Is that a guess?
Yes.
You're going on to tonight's Heart of Legend, Let's get up. All right, let's give a nice come on down, Campbell. Over you come. Come on, Debbie. There we are. Don't worry about it. We're still coming out for you. There we are. Thank you. You might go back with your wife there, Matt. There we go. All right. Can't believe you got it done there. All right, let's tell you what you're going to take away with you tonight. Now, we'll start up this end first, OK? Can we start here? Well, Carl and Carol, you're going to take away with you tonight the fridge freezer, a computer, the washing machine and £150. OK, and thank you for being great sorts, and thank you for all the help. OK, and we'll do this now, and each and every one of you will receive a copy of the game. And also, I'll get to you in a minute now. Reg and Debbie, you gave us all that entertainment at the beginning. You had a bit of bad luck with the questions. That's how they go. You haven't got anything at all. Which isn't very good. And as always, as a habit on here, what we're going to do, we're running your things over at the moment. You're getting a rough idea to see what you would have got there. And I'm going to bang the M one, I think, because I think that we'll be better off like that. So we'll take that one. Tell us, that's not a lot of good, is it? So let's see what we can give you as a prize to go away with anyway. A holiday in the Canaries, how about that? Well, it's up to the same thing. So is that OK? And that's thank you for all your entertainment. That's what it's all about. We're not worried about the game side, really. Don't worry about it. OK, well, that's the budget completely out the window. All right. Now, let's tell you, Matt and Eileen, what you're taking away with you tonight already. You've got a night out at the opera, a dinner service, a nest of tables, a week on the island of Kos, a chance now to win anything up to £3,000. Let's give them all a nice round of applause. Come back through here. And Eileen, here we go. Off you go, young man. And there we are. You go with your husband. Here we go. OK, Eileen, you just like to stand there, and Matt just beside the wife. OK. Here's how we're going to play the end game. You play the game as you did before, but this time you play the game horizontally and vertically. I'll ask you which move you want to make. You shout out top, middle or bottom. If you look at the screens there now, you can see we've got 10 arrows, 10 questions and 10 hotspots. If a question comes up, it'll be true or false. You give me an incorrect answer, it becomes a hotspot. For a correct answer, you gain another move. If you go for our top money tonight of £3,000, you cannot hit any more than two hotspots. For £2,000, no more than three, and £1,000, no more than four. If you go for our top money and you fail to get right the way across, we'll give you £300 for every successful move you make, and £200 for £2,000, and so on and so forth. All right, before you make your mind up, the computer will now jumble them all up. They're gone. All right, the prizes you got, the safe. OK, £1,000, £2,000 or £3,000. What do you think they should go for? What are you going to do?
Go for it.
They're going for the £3,000. Let's hear what Eileen's going to do. Over you come, Eileen. You have to stand down there, Matt. Just follow me over exactly the same gap we've got all the way, OK? All right, just look at the screen there now. Make your decision for your first £300, top, middle or bottom. Where do you want to go? The top one for your first £300? Yes! On our way, here we go. OK, for £600, top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
Bottom.
You made your mind up?
Bottom.
The bottom one for £600? Yes! Here we go, well done. OK, for £900, top, middle or bottom, where are you going to go? The bottom one again for the 900. Oh! OK, one hotspot gone, £600 is safe. We're going again for the 900 here. Just stand there. All right, the top, the middle or bottom for 900.
Middle.
The middle one for 900. Question. All right, you've got to get this right. You get it wrong, it becomes a hotspot. Here we go. Lizard Point, or as it is also known, Lizard Head, is the most southerly point of the British Isles. Is that true or false? Lizard Point, you can discuss it if you want, or as it's also known, Lizard Head, is the most southerly point of the British Isles. Is that true or is it false?
False.
It's true, I'm afraid. So that becomes a hot spot. OK, that's two gone.
Okay, now
you can't have any more at all, and if another true or false comes up, you've got to get it right. We're still on £600, we've got a long way to go yet, hopefully. All right, let's go for it again. Top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
Go for it.
No hot spot.
Top.
You go for it.
You go for it, go on. The top one for 900, come along. Question. He won't open his eyes. Hello? All right, here we go. In tennis, the score 40-all is called deuce. True or false?
True.
That's right, 900. Here we go. Over you come. All right, here we're getting... That's it. Now, we're going up into four figures now. For £1,200, top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
You can't.
Again? We're going up there? It's up to you. Go on, go for it. Yes? The middle one for £1,200. Oh, bad luck. Let's give him a nice round of applause. Come down, Matt. Never mind. Don't worry about it. Come down here. There we go, Eileen. Let's have a look at the screens. Let's see what they all were. There we go. There they are. Oh, you would have had it there. Never mind. Very difficult down the end there. Let's tell you what you're taking away with you tonight. You've got a night out at the opera, the dinner service, the Nessa tables, a week on the island of Kos, and £900 to take away with you as well. So not bad, Matt. Okay?
Not bad.
The exchange rate's not bad at the moment, so that's thousands of dollars. All right. Good night, God bless. All right, good night. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Are you nosy? I'm just asking because if the answer's yes, you might want to play as Lloyd Grossman goes through the keyhole. That's next and new on Challenge. Then you can't beat a bitter bully, so we're going to step up to the hockey weekdays at 5 for Bullseye.
Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Burnley's a small town, there's only 90,000 people that live here.
We are in a relegation battle.
I don't think these Americans understand Burnley.
And with that, Burnley are relegated from the Premier League.
This is a big ask for Vincent Kompany.
The detail he goes into is unbelievable.
Come on, go again!
He demands so much from us.
And we go, we beat them.
It's absolutely beautiful.
And we beat whatever comes after as well.
When you're down and people say you're not good enough, trust that we will finish on top.
Listen to the turf more roar.
If you needed a reason to stay with us, then we've got a million of them. Chris is here to play Classic Millionaire. Weeknights at 10, new on Challenge.
58, you've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Thank you. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Through the Keyhole, the show that knocks on the doors of the homes of the famous, finds they're out, but goes in anyway. Tonight, as every week, what we're going to do is to take the keys to two famous, fascinating houses owned by well-known people. And then, with Lloyd Grossman's help, our own original house detective, we'll be taking a privileged peep behind closed doors. But the question is, whose closed doors? Well, to try and find the answer to those questions, we've got three people here who are going to work at the answer. First of all, an author whose books will be read long after Shakespeare, Dickens, and Evelyn Waugh are forgotten. But not until then. Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Cox. Secondly, making a welcome return to the county they wish she'd never left, Mary Parkinson. And finally, a man with a bigger range of voices than the Huddersfield Choral Society, everyone's favourite carry-on comic, Kenneth Williams. Well, now, let me try and tell you a little more about the game. With the help of these magic keys, we'll be taking a careful look inside two fascinating homes, and that should tell us something, maybe a lot, about the person who lives there. All that our friends here have got to do, that's all, is just to work out whose house it is. So, let's join Lloyd Grossman now at house number one. And watch closely, because remember, the clues are there as we go through the keyhole.
Well, it's very rare to see such sophisticated taste in furniture, isn't it? In fact, this whole room is very sophisticated and very subtle. Once you close the door, you can't even find your way out of it. This is very much the sort of room where James Bond would have a drinks party. It's rather reminiscent of a penthouse suite in the Singapore Hilton. It does have very, very definite Far Eastern touches. There are a lot of Oriental knick-knacks scattered around. The lamps look like bunches of bamboo. There's a tremendous selection of bar paraphernalia. Look at all those glasses, for example. And I'm very impressed by the collection of miniatures at the top of the bar. This is a very well-appointed dressing room, isn't it? It's also frightfully butch with all this dark, polished wood. And look at this collection of shoes. Interestingly enough, they're all casual shoes. Maybe this belongs to a sort of laid-back guy who really likes walking. But the best thing about this room is on those mornings when you feel almost too tired to get dressed, just watch this. The mirrored ceiling is one of the best features of this bedroom. It's terribly handy because it means that when you make up the bed, you can see that the sheets are on straight. This is really a room designed for tremendous idleness, isn't it? I mean, look at that huge television set hanging over the bed. Whereas most people like to sleep with a teddy bear by their bedside, this person has a vintage Mercedes. One great luxury in here, and I really think every bedroom should have it, is provided by this little button. Let's press it and you just see what happens. As you may have guessed by now, everything in this house is connected to everything else. So if you're frolicking in the jacuzzi and you think that the local peeping Tom might be having a look at you, all you have to do is this. I think we'll leave this on autopilot. This room is quite interesting because it seems to be very traditional. Look at this fine Tudor paneling, for example, but it's not what it appears to be at all. What it really is a combination of Anne Hathaway's cottage and the Starship Enterprise, because this is the control center of the whole household. Look at this amazing array of switchcraft next to me. From this sofa, you can control everything. Let's just flick a switch and watch what happens.
Much more than this, I didn't
mind. And of course, as Frank Sinatra croons slowly in the background on the stereo and you fancy a bite to eat, you don't even have to move from here. Just watch this. Talk about convenience food. The only problem is knowing when to stop. Let's review the evidence. The hotel bar, the mirrored ceiling over the bed, the push-button mania. The question is, what sort of person lives in a place like this? So, David, it's over to you.
Thank you very much indeed, Lloyd. So now, for our home and studio audience, though not for our panel, here's whose house it is. Alan, it's your turn to begin the analysis.
Lloyd said the interesting thing about his shoes, they were all casual. I noticed they were all black. The only person I ever knew had all black shoes was an undertaker. I think this bloke probably drives a hearse. I also noticed all that crystal, which nobody in their right mind would ever buy. I think he shops at Texaco gas stations a lot. And they are all... Is he a driver of some kind?
All right, Mary. Well, you said yes, a driver.
Yes, that's a good clue. And there was a car. I noticed a racing car. Now let's see what we've got. Well, what did I notice? I noticed a very small chair. So maybe he's a very small man, but he's certainly dapper and he likes high tech. I think he's got a very understanding wife. I think he's a man who's never put away his toys. I think he's probably designed that house himself, because if it goes wrong, he's going to be the only man who's going to be able to fix it.
Kenneth, what picture did you get?
Well, it's absolutely staggering. I mean, first of all, I thought it must be somebody exotic, you know, and films. I thought of films because of all that sheesh, I mean, all the stuff coming down off the wall and the mirrors over in the bedroom. And then I thought, well, no, because I think Lloyd gave us a deliberate clue with the Mercedes motor car. It must be someone with a tremendous sort of international status, I would have thought. International celebrity status. You know,
right.
Grand Prix.
Oh, very good, Tom.
Right.
Something like that.
Well, who wants to try first?
I think we know this now, don't we? I mean,
yeah,
it's significant that
it.
It's a Mercedes-Benz because he used to drive for them. It's got to be Stirling Moss, hasn't it?
Correct! Stirling Moss coming through the keyhole. Well, they were hot stuff there, yeah. Stirling, weren't they?
Terrible, didn't they?
sorted out that fast.
Stage by stage, analysed.
What happens if you get a fuse blown? Are you stuck in bed or with the table halfway up?
No, because there are quite a lot of circuits. There are about 196 operations working through, I think, 70-odd circuits. So each one is underloaded, so you're not likely to overload it and blow a fuse. If it does blow a fuse, one of those trigger things comes up and you just push it, find it and push it down.
Do you have an understanding wife?
Yeah, oh, I do. Absolutely. I mean, she's moved it. It was designed when I was a bachelor. And now you saw the table come down. Well, Susie, if she's in the kitchen cooking, I say, OK, and then I start to bring... If she's fast, she can get down before it comes down and closes off where we're sitting. So she's quick as well.
So then and if she doesn't get there in time?
Well, she has to stand outside. No, I can't stop.
And what about when you're busy and you decide to run a bath? What if you forget and get busier on the phone or something? Does the bath overflow?
The bath runs for 5 minutes, 20 seconds, and then about 240 gallons in that sports suit a bath, and then it stops. And if somebody else pushes the button, not knowing that I have, it lights up. But if they do, then it just empties it. In other words, it's on a full empty. So, touch wood, it can't overflow.
It can't.
Is that really your design, or is it somebody who has done it for you?
Oh, no, it's my design. Oh, no, I'm not a lazy person, but I do like to be able to get on with what I'm doing. So if I need a bath, I put my hand out, push a button, and I can carry on with what I'm doing. So I know it's ready in 5 minutes.
Is the mirror over the bed a labour-saving device, or what?
No, that's there for... Well, that's I was a bachelor at one time, and that lets down... There's a sun lamp above that, actually.
Have you ever tried to put it on the market? People come along and say...
No, I wouldn't, because it's my home, and I'd hate to do it, but it would be difficult to find the right person, but there are other people who are as crazy as I am who would buy a place like that, I hope.
Well, Sterling, we have here, as a memento of our thanks to you, the gold through the keyhole key to present you, to say thank you for sharing this time with us. We appreciate it very much.
Thank you
very
much.
We've got to take a break there, and in a moment, Lloyd will be going to house number two, but in the meantime, our thanks to Sterling Moss. We'll be right back.
Oh, 22, you'll be good at this one.
Discover the surprising details of your ancestors' lives with our ever-growing collection of historical records. Start your free trial today at Ancestry.
Your dog's gorgeous.
Isn't she?
Can you believe we got her to protect our home?
Verisure Alarm is all you need. 24/7 monitoring. Get to check on Crusher if you pop out.
Good idea.
Isn't it, Crusher?
Verisure Alarms. Get a free indoor camera installed with your Zero Vision alarm installation. Call now or visit verisure.co.uk.
My funeral plans arrived.
Oh, right, Mum. Great.
Is your mum all right?
Oh, yeah. She's just,
Granny says she wants to get things sorted now, so we won't have to worry about it.
Oh, it's pure cremation, Jean. Here, have a look. When I go, they'll take care of the practical bit and bring my ashes home. It's all sorted and paid for, so my family won't have the worry. No fuss, no hidden costs. Just what I want.
Oh, I see.
And Granny says we'll have to have a party and remember the nice things. But it won't be for ages yet.
Find out why the UK's best-selling plan is the simple, fuss-free, pure cremation plan. Rated excellent on Trustpilot with over 13,000 reviews. Chat to our lovely people by calling now on 0800 170 7098 or visit purecremation.tv.
Holidays always cost more than you expect, don't they? The new pair of sunglasses at the airport, the cheeky lunchtime pina colada with Libara. One cost you don't have to worry about is EU roaming charges. Because, unlike most networks, with Libara, there aren't any. They're all about saving you money. Just like this ad. No Hollywood actors here. That's why they hired me, Layla, from Pearly.
Libara. Smarter.
Yes, could I get a pina colada?
Are you looking for a way to give your finances a much-needed boost? With an equity release mortgage from Key, you could unlock a portion of your home's value tax-free and have the option to make reduced or no monthly repayments. So why not find out more by ordering our free expert guide on 0800 188 4822 or using our free calculator to see how much you could release. See how Key could help put more money back in your pocket. Key, for the life in later life.
Sometimes we put off the important things, like helping to provide financial protection for your family if the worst should happen.
Welcome to Smart Insurance. You're speaking to Lisa. How may I help you?
Hi. Your advert for life insurance says I can arrange cover over the phone with no complicated forms.
Yes, that's right. As long as you're a UK resident, aged 18 to 64, you can apply for a benefit amount of £60,000 up to £750,000.
Great.
You won't need a medical or a blood test, just a few health and lifestyle questions to answer. I just need to get your age and smoker status.
I'm 32 and a non-smoker.